Well, in a few short weeks, George Street will be buzzing with the hum of a new light rail. But thanks to rare film found by the National Film and Sound Archive that retraces the same route with Sydney's original trams, we get an opportunity tonight to travel the city's main thoroughfare of more than a century ago.
The view from the tram driver's cabin up George Street from the quay in 2019 and in 1906.
We're not seeing some posed event happening. This is life in Sydney.
As the tram passes Hunter Street, a boy crosses the tracks pushing a pan and broom, known as a block boy.
A young man who was employed by the council to push manure, to clean up the streets. There are no traffic lights, and there's just a flow of people going every which way.
As 1906 passes Martin Place, the camera pans slightly to pick up the umbrellas of the post office flower sellers before heading towards King Street and cross tram traffic as boater-clad men and widows in black dart across the steel in the road.
The fact that she's out and about in public means that she's probably at least 6 months into her mourning period.
The dome of the QVB, built 8 years earlier, already dominates George Street as it does now.
It was probably one of the first times that people had seen it on film, captured in this 1906 view of George Street.
But with the light rail about to roll next month, there is one modern day problem the horse and cart days never faced: the hypnotism induced by the smartphone.
No one really remembers back to when there were trams, and so people have to get used to it.
Earbuds weren't such a big problem in 1906.
Mike Dalton, Nine News.